God, we acclaim you as the Lord. The glorious company of apostles praise you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus passed by, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the customs post. He said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He heard this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners.'" My dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers in Christ.
Good afternoon.
Peace and blessings to everyone. Today we celebrate the feast day of Saint Matthew, apostle, evangelist, patron saint of tax collectors, customs officers, and accountants. Saint Matthew is an apostle, meaning to say Christ chose Matthew among the 12 apostles to share in his ministry of evangelization, in his passion, death, and resurrection. Saint Matthew is also an evangelist. Christian tradition attributes to Saint Matthew the writing of the Gospel of Matthew. And the symbol of Saint Matthew is a winged man. According to Saint Jerome, Saint Matthew focuses on the humanity of Jesus, presenting the genealogy of Jesus. Indeed, Jesus is 100% divine inasmuch as he is 100% human. Third, he is also a tax collector. He is apostle, evangelist, but perhaps we would most remember Matthew as being a tax collector. When you are a tax collector, during the time of Jesus, two things. First, you are considered a traitor because you are working for the enemy, the Romans. Jerusalem was under the Roman Empire. Second, when you are a tax collector during the time of Jesus, you are considered a thief, an extortionist. Napakayaman ni Mateo, napakamakapangyarihan, pero nilalayuan, kinamumuhian ng kanyang kapwa. He is perhaps successful, super rich, but deep inside, he feels sick. Something is missing in him. At nakita ho ng ating Panginoong Jesus si Mateo. Ganun ho kapag tinitingnan tayo ng Diyos. Yes, nakikita ng Diyos ang ating mga kahinaan, ang ating karupukan, ang ating mga kasalanan. Pero nakikita rin ng Diyos sa atin ang kanyang kawangis. We are made in the image and likeness of God. Sabi nga ng isang Irish poet and playwright na si Oscar Wilde, every saint has a past. Every sinner has a future. Three important things. First, when we speak about God's love, it is all-embracing, inclusive. God's heart is big enough to embrace everyone. Saints, sinners, self-righteous. Kuminsan, iniisip natin o pinagninilayan natin ang pagmamahal ng Diyos. Kailangan natin gumawa ng kabutihan para mahalin tayo ng Diyos. Pero ang katotohanan, bago pa tayo gumawa ng kabutihan, mahal na tayo ng Diyos. God loves us not because we're good, but God will make us good because He loves us. Kuminsan iniisip rin natin, naku, Father, gumawa ako ng mabigat na kasalanan. Ibig sabihin ba nun, eh, hindi na ako mahal ni Lord? You know, when we sin, it is we ourselves who stop loving as we turn our back on pure love. When we sin, it is not God who stops loving because He is always pure love. It is we ourselves who stop loving as we turn our back on pure love. Second, God's love is not only inclusive, it is for every day. Whatever we do, the invitation to love, to follow the Lord, is always there. You know, in the gospel reading today, Jesus called Matthew while he is in the customs post. Habang siya ay nagtatrabaho. Siguro ho, naisip ko ni Matthew habang pinag-iisipan niya, no, magkano kaya ang aking makokolekta? And that was the time that our Lord Jesus called him. You know, Mother Teresa of Calcutta would say, holiness is doing ordinary things with extraordinary love. Whatever we do, halimbawa, kapag kayo ay nag-prepare ng breakfast, lunch, dinner, kayo ay nagluluto, naglilinis ng bahay, nasa opisina, there is the call of holiness wherever we are, whatever we do. Now, the question is our work, our occupation, leading us closer to the deeper things, the greater things, or leads us away from the greater things? Natagpuan ni Jesus ng Diyos si Mateo sa kanyang trabaho. At pinahintulutan ni Mateo ang kanyang sarili na matagpuan siya ng Diyos. Kumusta po ang inyong trabaho? Are you enjoying your work? Yes or no? Nag-e-enjoy ho ba kayo sa trabaho ninyo? Is your work, your mission, making you holier, happier, healthier? Father, yung aking trabaho, I feel burned out. Burnout is real, but Judith is more real. Judith, kaya kailangan ko magtrabaho. You know, sometimes burnout is not caused by a lack, by hard work, by overwork. But burnout is caused by meaningless work. When we can find no meaning at all in our work, we feel tired. And from here, from the experience of Matthew, we allow God for us to encounter Him in our work. And finally, God's love is not only inclusive, it's not only for every day, it is also transformative. Ang pagmamahal ng Diyos, it's not only comforting, consoling, but also it is confronting. It challenges us to grow, to become the best and the better version of ourselves. You know, our Lord Jesus, He loved to dine with sinners, with prostitutes, with tax collectors during that time. He dined with them. He loved them. He welcomed them. But He never raised a glass to prostitution, to theft, to extortion. Ang pagmamahal ng Diyos, binabago tayo. Binabago ang ating isipan, ang ating ugali, ang ating ugnayan sa isa't isa. My dear friends in Christ, may God's love truly transform us to become the best, the better version of ourselves, like what He did to Matthew. Amen.